around here call us deserters. Others say that we're bandits, bloodsuckers, renegades. Those Yankees. Those goddamn filthy Yankees are now saying that they won the war. That they've defeated us. That we're destroyed. That the South is lost. That the Confederacy is in ruins. That the rebels have been entirely wiped out. But take a good look at yourselves. Dead are you? You can still all feel, eat, and drink. You can all remember your loved ones back home. And you can still kill. I tell you this, the Yankees haven't seen the last of us, not by a long shot. Be faithful to your colonel and your honor. We'll have to bide our time a few more years in this scummy place at the edge of the world. But this sacrifice will be worth it because we'll return as soldiers. Not as victims. Not as miserable, greedy slaves. But as masters. Those damn Yankees will have another war on their hands. Our war. And this one will win!
My darling child.
Everything's loaded in the wagon. Whiskey, guns.
Did you remember these? Blank ammunition? Yeah. In case they ever point those guns at us.
And what's your decision about that girl? Chief Black Eagle's daughter.
I want her. That girl's a beauty. So lovely and wild. Just the way I like it.
And what if the old chief makes problems?
In that case, you know just what to do. Go!
Forward! Yeah. Ah! Oh.
Daughter's dead. Can't you understand that? You old witch. I don't want to see a photograph around here anymore. Get rid of them. You hear? You're a darn fool, Mary. My daughter's dead. There's nothing you or I can do about it.
It's all your fault. That she died.
What the hell are you saying? You're mad!
Oh, no. You are the one who is mad. You and your damn stupid pride, your cruelty, and your thirst for blood and power that has brought dishonor on our house and destroyed everything you loved. Yes. Yes. You are the cause of what happened to our daughter.
Oh, no, stop! Be quiet!
No!
Or I'll kill you.
Kill you. honey. What's your hurry, eh? Let me have a look at you. Yes, what the hell were you doing here?
I bring the key for Dolores, senor.
Oh, you did, eh?
Si, senor. Manuel, he bring me tequila.
Really? Well, isn't that thoughtful of him? What else did you bring for Dolores, eh? This, maybe, huh? If I catch you hanging around here again, I'll cut it off! Well, now, what were you planning to give your little friend in return for his tequila, eh? Tell me, huh?
Nothing. Nothing, I swear.
You're a pretty bitch, Dolores. A filthy slut. You belong to me, do you hear? Now, don't you forget that. Now, if you're nice and loving with me, I might let you have your precious Manuel. As a gift. Soon. Very soon. Black Eagle. Oh, we've come to trade. We want to buy many horses. Young Mustangs.
Our horses are away at pasture in the hills. You must wait for their return. Our warrior braves are with them and will come back when moon changed to time. But your eyes say horses not all you want trade for something else. What?
You're right. My master, you see, wants to trade for your daughter, Yaren. She'll be happy with the colonel. And look what he offers for her. Whiskey, yes, and guns, with plenty of ammunition.
My daughter is sacred. She has taken a vow to the great Manitou. She cannot go with any man of her own tribe or of yours. She has sworn this before the Great Spirit. She has promised.
My master, the colonel, is very generous. He wants to help your tribe. He knows all your needs, Black Eagle. Think of the good you can do your people. He's willing to pay whatever you ask.
My answer is no.
You better think that over. Because we might just take both of your daughters.
Hi.
Hi there, looking for a soldier boy?
Stop! Let it go!
Stop, Black Eagle!
I think of killers!
Welcome to our tribe, little Indian slut.
Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May God watch over your souls. Rest in peace. Amen.
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 Boy,
it
sure is hard work.
Yeah, I'm dying of thirst.
Thank goodness there's a creek here.
Are you thirsty? Frank, give us some water.
Vince wouldn't like that, Gordon. He'd turn in his grave if I do it. He was my best friend. Let the whore suffer and die of thirst.
The Colonel wants this woman, and we have to take her to him alive. Do you understand?
Over.
Fool! Oh, goddamned idiot! You let her get away! Damn ya!
I bet she's returned to her people. We'll find her there. You can bet on it.
No, not a chance. She's got no more people to go back to, have you forgotten? That squaw's too smart. She's still around here. She's somewhere down in that valley. Someplace. Got away.
If only we had some dogs.
Hey, there's someone who's better than a whole pack of hounds. You know, that Indian guy, Hondo, the half-breed. Let's get him. You shoot first and ask questions after, huh?
Hondo has made many enemies. And some of them are you, Paleface.
Oh, look, Hondo, I got work for you. And there'll be plenty of firewater if you do the job well. We're tracking down a squaw who killed some of my men. And you're the only fella smart enough to follow her trail.
Thank you.
Hold it. Don't move or I'll blow your head off. Who did this to you? Do you understand? You stink like a wild animal. That eye's infected. You're running away from someone, aren't you? Just nod your head. Who is it? Who's after you? Ah, the hell with you.
Teach you leaves.
What leaves?
Arigaki. Make you forget you're hungry, tired. This way. Hide in here.
Where did she go next? In her condition, she can't move very fast.
This squaw not stupid. She very cunning, very strong.
All I want to know is, where the hell has she got to?
She go that way, to Thunder Mountain.
Oh.
that way.
There's a lot of farms and ranchers over in that direction.
Them ranchers hate the Indians. Why, they might even kill her.
The trail's still fresh. She's not far away from here.
That's my bed, and I'm going to sleep in it tonight. You understand? You could use that blanket for a dress. You understand what I'm saying? Dress. All right. Better eat if you want to get well. Don't bother thanking me for helping you. This time, don't throw it on the floor. You know, it's no pleasure for me having you here. Skin.
The murders is not us. They are the pale face. Oh, I've murdered my father, murdered my people. The men who butchered babies. They burned everything. Took women. Did as they like. It is they who are the savage.
Listen here. I had nothing to do with it. Who are these men, huh? You know?
Soldiers. The long-range knives. Their chief is Colonel Connor.
Sleep here for one more night. But tomorrow, you go. Is that clear?
Whose grave is that?
My wife's. She is raped. Killed by Indians.
I am an Indian. Why you not kill?
What for? Revenge? Revenge means only more killing. More raping. More scalps. Revenge? It won't bring back my Emma. Is nearly better now. At least you won't have any more fever. But you have to eat if you want to get your strength back. Otherwise, you won't get far. Don't you want it?
You want to help, yet you treat Yaring like a dog. You speak with forked tongue. I'm Yaring, not Coyote. Yaring is the same as you. Connor's men. I hear them coming.
Hide in the stable. Bar yourself in. Go on.
Enjoy stopping by here, Matt. It's almost like coming home. Maybe you don't wear a uniform no more, but you're still one of us.
How you keeping, Gordon?
Great. And so would you be if you hadn't resigned your commission, Lieutenant. And your wife would still be alive.
You never change, do you, Sergeant? What's the Indian looking for?
That's Hondo, my hunting dog. Especially his renegades.
I don't like lousy redskins snooping around my ranch.
The footprints come here.
Who are you looking for anyway, Gordon?
Little Comanche squaw the Colonel's got his eye on. She managed to run away when we were taking her back to him.
I know she here someplace. She hiding in house.
You're not going to listen to an Indian.
Oh, of course not. But do you mind if we take a little look in the stable? No, no, hold it, man. Don't shoot. Don't shoot. We fought together. We fought for the same things. Don't you remember that?
Yeah. The things you fought for. Like rape and robbery. The uniform to protect you. You and your friends.
It's all very well for you to talk now, but in those days you weren't any better. You may have really changed. But you'll pay for hiding that Indian.
Bastard. Clear off, before I change my mind.
You're already dead, but you don't know it! Ah! Ah!
Thank you.
You are a white man. A Wasiku. A long-range knife. You hate Indians. Why did you kill for me?
I'm no longer a long gray knife. And I had to kill that man. To save my skin, not yours.
You think they come back?
Yes.
So be it. Fate is the same for you and me. I will go now. We separate. I manage alone.
We'll be stronger together. Connor can be stubborn. He'll stop at nothing. But maybe there's a way out. If we can make it to the mountains tonight.
We can't keep up this pace a hell of a lot longer. We'll kill the horses.
The hell with the horses. I want to get away.
It ain't fair that we gotta freeze our asses out here while them two are inside all nice and cozy. And doing guess what? Enjoy your lay, Lieutenant. You'll never have another. Know something? I'm getting worried. It's much too quiet. We ought to take a closer look. If those two get away, Connor will slit our throats. Ain't no sign of movement. I'm going on down there. You hear any shooting, you come running.
The hell, there's a ravine. Well, we can't go back. I have to get across it.
Here,
hold my gun.
Thank you.
That's it. Grab hold of me. That's the way.
You made it.
Hold it right there. Don't cry anything, or you're dead.
It ain't worth it. Drop your gun. It's a damn dirty shame, spoiling your honeymoon. Only your squaw here belongs to the colonel.
That bastard! Hey!
He sure is taking plenty of time.
What if he's in trouble or something? Maybe he needs us.
I don't like this. We should have all stuck together and not let Frank go prowling around on his own. You know what I think? I think we ought to go down there and take a look.
He's strong. He lost. Now I take his strength.
Savages. All you do is mutilate and torture. Why do you have to do things like that?
We don't use breasts to make tobacco pouch like Wasiku soldiers.
That's a lie. It's a lie.
Not lie. I speak truth. You not see my village after white men come. You not see women after soldiers rape and kill. You no see soldiers gouge eyes out of old men and cut the heads off of little children. You see or you no see.
What the hell was that? Let's go have a look.
Okay, we've gone far enough for tonight. We'll rest here until daybreak. We better be careful. I'll take the first watch.
No, I'm not tired. I keep watch.
Whatever you say.
Your throat.
He was supposed to watch him. He let him slip right through his fingers.
I don't understand. Maybe he sees them sneaking away and he's following them.
Colonel Carter!
Sir, I found Frank's body. That damn squaw scalped him.
Let's not waste any more time. Come on!
Yeah! Here!
Yeah.
don't like this place. It's too quiet.
Shahatian, the sacred hill.
Oh! Found the bodies of Chris and Billy. Both of them were scalped.
As they climb the ridge in that direction. Peter, you take three men and circle around that way. Gordon, you, Mike and Spencer, come with me. The rest of you, search the slope. Peter, you guard the canyon. They can't get away this time.
This is Shahaptian, the house of the dead, the land of my ancestors. My father say, everyone has guiding spirit. And even the white man has guiding spirit in his body. I not die, you see, as long as the spirit of my father shows the way and stays within me. As the spirit of your wife guides you. The souls we love dearly stay in us. Love is like hate. It never dies.
Tell me, who are they?
They are my tribe, my people, warriors. You know Move, I speak. This Wasiku helped me. He risked his life more than once. He not enemy. He good friend.
No white man, good friend. Paleface kill own people. We take oath, must kill all Wasiku and scalp. And you, little squaw, you go. Away.
I am Yaring, daughter of Great Chief Black Eagle. Not little squaw, go away.
What's happening?
He spoke bad of me. I spoke bad of him. I made insult.
Topa! Ishi! Heya! Besto!
What does he want now?
I say Red Fox no strong. Make only talk, have no courage. He thinks he's great warrior, very strong. He wants fight.
Naku!
I don't want to fight.
You must. If not, warriors kill us. If you fight and win, we free. It is the law.
It's a crazy law. I still don't want to fight.
Are you afraid to be killed? You think Red Fox is too strong, Wasiku?
What are you doing?
Yaring cold. You warm. Yaring takes warmth from your body.
But, we mustn't stay like this.
Why?
Why? Because women and men who aren't married shouldn't sleep together.
Oh, I don't understand. You can explain it tomorrow.
I ain't tired. Here, take the blanket. It'll keep you warm. Yeah.
Aladdin, daughter of the running waters, child of mine. Remember the words of your father, Black Eagle. The spirit is in all of us. It lives on in the hair after death.
Peter.
Well, seems like he's bagged some game. He always was a good hunter.
Come on, move!
Howdy, Colonel.
Who are these two?
They're hiding up in the hills. They say they're like gorillas run off from their village. Like they're on their honeymoon.
Hold on. Let me look at you. You're pretty, aren't you?
Shoot him, bastard! Let me shoot the stinking coyote.
Give me a knife, Pat.
Colonel wants him alive.
Get off. Come on. Get going. Go. Come on, Paleface. We must hide. You're strong. Stronger than what is hurting you. Come on. Wake up. The soldiers are near. Back. Be quiet.
Thank you.
stupid idiot! You let him get away! You're a fool! I'll teach you! Darn you!
Easy, Colonel, you'll kill him!
I'm going to skin him alive! That scum, he had him cornered, and then he let him get away!
Here, have a drink, it'll calm you down. We'll get him. Don't worry, they can't go anywhere. Matt's wounded and she's just a squaw. We'll go on hunting tomorrow morning.
All right.
Is all right?
I think it's all right. At least I can move it.
Paleface strong. You'll heal quickly.
What I don't understand is why my head pains so.
Eat this. Good. Give you strength.
Good. What is it?
Ochika. Snake.
Snake.
Well cooked. Very good.
It's delicious.
Yarin used secret root, old Indian medicine gone wood. Soon feel well, but also feel very strange. Ochika is love sign to us, and Indian brave eat it before they lay with squaw.
You know, I do feel strange.
Now Yarin belongs to you.
What would you put in that snake?
I'm a savage, a barbarian. Remember?
I've changed my mind.
And you hate redskins, my people.
You're not like the others.
No, wait. Do not toy with Yarin. Please.
I want to kiss you.
Only if you really want, it'll bring our souls together. Indian legend has story of squaw, daughter to chief who fall in love with a great warrior from far away. At first they have very much trouble because of strange customs, but they begin to learn the ways of each other and to love. My brave, from far away. We will be as them happy forever.
Over here. Get down.
How do we get to the hills?
At night. We walk in shadows. The soldiers won't see. Trouble is they have horses. And are many.
We'll wait until sunset. Then we can get away. Let's go.
Take horses quickly.
Who I found.
Now, what do you say we have a little talk, Matt? No, better if you do the talk. Now, tell me. Just what do you think we ought to do, huh? With you and that filthy little squaw of yours.
You can do whatever you like, Connor. You and I have nothing further to say to each other. Just save your breath.
Well, since you don't want to cooperate, I guess I'll have to decide. Now, seeing that you seem to have taken up with those Indians, I'll show you a nice little Indian toy. And this is my first chance to play with it. Here it is. Oh, this is going to be fun. Eh?
Thank you.
I want you to help me. I want you to be the bait. I want you to shout just as loud as you possibly can so your little Indian whore will come out in the open. She won't be able to resist. I want your shouts of pain to drill through our Indian brain. But then... Track her down, Sergeant. And from now on, you better carry out my commands on the double. Or maybe instead of her, you'll be the one to suffer. Come on!
Wait a minute!
All this hassle.
You must have come through here.
What are you looking for, anyway?
I don't like the way the Colonel's behaving. Wasting all this time over that engine gal.
Charlie! Charlie! Jay Sully!
Don't worry about that gal. You're hoping that somehow she'll turn up here and save your hide. I'm afraid you'll be disappointed, because when she does turn up, you'll be a prisoner. And the pair of you won't have time for hardly anything, just a goodbye kiss. Did you hear me?
You bastard. Bastard! Bastard!
We'll keep this coyote with us. I don't want to kill him yet. Not till the score is settled.
She is!
What's wrong, man? Are you tired already? Oh, I used to be a real tough soldier. One of my best. Now look at you. Sniveling like a baby.
You're out of your mind, Carter. You're out of your mind. You're crazy.
No. You're wrong. You're crazy, man. You get worse, because this is just the beginning. Let's go. Come on, boys.
You killed my father, Paleface! You massacred my family and my people!
Come on out!
Traitor, man. You're a traitor to me, to the Army, to the Confederacy, and to the South. You betrayed the ideals we fought for, and you're going to be punished for it. Punished like you deserve. I sent you to death, Lieutenant, but shooting is too good for the likes of you, so I'm going to wait until we get a hold of that little Indian slut of yours. I'm going to skin both you and that bitch alive.
Look out, he's got a gun!
No. No. No!
Thank you.
I hate you, man, for taking her away. You stole my child. You stole her and married her.
What do you mean?
The one person that I ever loved. She meant everything to me. Matt, I remember the day she died. You were out hunting. I went to visit her, to persuade her to leave you, to make her see that you were wrong for her, to at least have some pity for me.
You can't be serious.
She just didn't want to listen. And when I pleaded, when I begged, she began yelling and shouting and saying awful things about me. And she even said that she hated to call me father.
I can understand her hating you, Connor.
Then I realized the only thing I can do, cleanse her of all the hatred inside her, make her stop being ashamed of me. So I took her naked in my hands, and I squeezed and felt her heart no longer beating.